see, we live in a world, we're told we're not supposed to preach on sin anymore. Amen? You can't preach on sin. You can't tell somebody you're a sinner anymore because you're going to be judgmental. And Jesus said, judge not, lest you be judged. And those fools obviously don't realize in that exact same chapter, Jesus said, beware of the false prophet because there are wolves in sheep's clothing. In the exact same chapter. Amen? But we're not supposed to preach on sin anymore. We're supposed to make people feel comfortable. We're supposed to make people feel cozy. We're supposed to make the sinner feel welcome. We're supposed to make the sinner feel okay in his sin. And his sin is all right and you just come right on in. Let me tell you what's not going to take place in hell. You want me to tell you what's never, ever, ever going to take place in hell? That sinner that sat in that comfortable church for all of those years and even decades, and he never heard the gospel preached, he never heard Jesus preached, he never heard the word repent preached, proclaimed even one single time. Let me tell you what's not going to happen in hell. He's not going to walk up to his pastor. Now, his pastor might be there, and he's going to say, well, pastor, what are you doing here? And the pastor's going to say, well, I was busy building bigger barns and then my soul was required of me this very night. Amen? I got snatched out of that $12 million home and my soul was required of me this very night. That's why I'm here, because I was too busy building bigger barns rather than trying to preach the gospel message of the Lord Jesus Christ. Well, pastor, now this is not going to happen in hell. I promise you this. Well, pastor, I sure do wish you'd have told me about Jesus. I sure do wish you'd have preached on repentance. I sure do wish you'd have warned me about hell. I sure do wish you'd have proclaimed the gospel. But, pastor, I want to thank you for making me comfortable in church all those years. That is not going to happen. I can promise you that. Amen? If the sinner comes into the church, we need to welcome everybody into the church. Amen? We've had folks come to New Life Baptist Church that we had to help them in because they were so drunk we thought they were going to fall down. Well, praise God they're here, but while they're here, they're going to hear the gospel. Amen? Now, they could leave just as lost as they came in, but that's their choice. We welcome them here. We're glad they're there. We'd rather them be there than out there. Amen. We've had homosexual couples come into our church and we come right on in. But while you're here, we're going to preach the gospel to you. Amen. Amen. We're going to tell you what you need to do to be saved. And it's up to you whether you receive it or reject it. But we told you the truth and there's no blood on our hands. Amen.